Hello guys, welcome to another edition of our tutorial video. This is Parrot TV. In this video, we'll be teaching you how to make a cartoon animation as beautiful as what you're seeing on your screen now. Make sure you don't miss any part of the video. Follow us. We are Parrot TV. We don't only entertain you, we get you skilled up. Follow up in the class. Good day, wherever you are watching this video. This is Parrot TV. Welcome to another edition of our tutorial. In this section of the tutorial, we'll be teaching you how to make cartoon animation, and we've started so far so good. We've worked on 3 apps out of the 4 applications we planned to use for this tutorial. No, I told you when I wanted to start the first video that we'll be using 4 applications to make cartoons. So we'll use 3 to make the last one, which is Autodesk. Started from Remini, we moved to Snapseed, from Snapseed, we moved to Pixel Pro, and now we are in Autodesk, which is the main app for our cartoon animation. So what you do now is go to the picture. This is the last picture we worked on, so on Pixel Pro. But I'm thinking of making, instead of cropping it like this, I want to use the original picture. I mean the one of Snapseed. So let's go and check. Yes, this one itself. If you like, you can just crop yours. But as for me, I don't want to crop it. Okay, understand. Now you share your picture to Autodesk. Now I said it's Autodesk is the real place where we'll be doing a lot of work. So make sure you watch your video very well. So look at what it brings. As a new user, it needs to store your brush data and sketches to your device. Click on OK. So allow it. These are things Autodesk will ask you. You've been a new user of the application. So now we are in the application. I don't know why you're showing this, but that's not a problem. That's not a problem. I know what to do. Okay, so you know what? First of all, create a new layer. And to create a new layer, look at what I clicked on. Click on this plus icon. Look at, I've created another layer, created more layer. So create a new layer. So sorry, I'm trying to do something. Yeah, you know what I did now for a picture to move? I moved this. I'm coming, let me I click on this picture. Let me take return it. I click on the picture and I move it to the upper layer. Now this background, if you off it, you can on it. This also, you can off it, you can on it. So now our picture is showing. Please, if your picture is blank the way you should do that, make sure you just move it above the first layer. And to move it above the first layer, click on it and hold it and drag a little bit. Okay, so bring it back. So now I'll be explaining so many things. Guess what I'm praising now? Okay, it's kind of explaining it. Can go through it, but I'll be clicking on God seat. So you see what I'm clicking on, and you see what it's showing. Now I'll be explaining it. Remember what I first told you is to show your layer, to kind of view your layers, you click on here. Hope you can see where I clicked on. Yeah. Look at the place that is showing now. So above it, yeah. Click on it. you see your layers, and I've explained how to create a new layer. You click on this addition button to create new layer. So let's go back here. You see this small dot, let me zoom it. See this small dot here. So you can zoom also. See anything I'm doing, and I'm saying you will understand. You can zoom and you can so just kind of place your two hands on it and zoom in and zoom out. So you see this small dot here. Once you click on it, it will show 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 things plus these two here. That's 7. So now let me explain what everything is for. You see this, if you click on it, it's going to bring out your brushes. Look at what I clicked on. All this one, just leave it. It won't bring it again after it stopped bringing it. It won't bring it again. Look at this. This showing 3.7. It is pencil. So you click on it, it's going to show you a list of your pencils. So we have so many pencils on Autodesk, and I'll be telling you the one we'll be using for our tune once we want to start our cartoon animation. But for a start, I want to explain everything, all the things, all the tools on Autodesk, because it's kind of complicated. So look at settings now. Can decrease the size, so I can decrease the opacity, so you can just leave the size in 2.7 for now. So remember, if you want to change your size, your pencil, click here, and so normally it's going to show you library. You have library, you have settings. Once you choose your pencil, let's say I don't want that, I want this. Let me pick my smudge pencil. That's the only reason. Use my smudge pencil. Yeah, it's still not the one. Okay. So let's say I pick this pink pencil. Look at, I can increase the size here in the settings option. See, it's coming big, and I can raise the opacity. So that's for that. You see this one showing black, it is for you to change your color. If I click on it, I'll be able to pick color. Look at, let's say I want yellow, I'll move it to yellow side. Can you see my color is yellow? And if I kind of do it, can you see it's showing yellow color? Now I'll do something now. You see, I use my brush to kind of paint something here on the picture, a yellow picture on the picture. So if I want to erase it, I just have to do a few things. You see this back icon, if I click on it, it's going to go, it's just like undo. Yeah, it's not even like it is undo, this is undo. Now if I want it to come back, I'll click on this right hand icon. Can you see that redo? If you can see what I click on here, thing is around here. You can see here I'm tapping now. Sorry. Now I want all this thing I did. Look at what I did on the hand. I want it to leave the face. What I was just doing is click on undo. And see, it's disappearing. Now it's no more there. This two, if I want to undo them also. This two that is kind of big here. So let's undo them. So, trim one. Can you see it is no mountain? Let's see, I still want it there. I'll just click on redo. This is redo. Can you see it? Now it's there again. So, I don't want it. I'll just click on undo. Hope you get that. Now, another thing you should know is undo is derived from eraser. We have eraser also. You get to know that soon. So now I'm going to draw. Okay, let's practicalize again. Let's change our color. It is yellow before. If you want to change our color, I told you we click on this. Then we change the color to the color you want. Let's say we want blue. Let's shift it. Yeah, so it's blue. So change it as well. Do you want it to be bold? I want it to be very good. I'll be putting it in. Then you cancel it. Can you see it's now blue? So if I write it, if I drew something, can you see it's showing blue? Now look at this. Look at this. Something like pencil showing beside the undo, showing here. I've not clicked on it, I'm intentionally clicking on outside so I can know where it's showing. Can you see I'm pointing now? Once I click on this, you are going to see it. Can you see it now? So I will click on it now. You yourself, I want you to notice what happened once I click on it. Now, what does it bring? It brought last brush. Now, click here. What do you notice that changes? Our brush has changed. So this is used to change brushes. Look at it now. I click on it again. Can you see it has changed our brushes? So let me change the brush myself. Go to library. So I want to change to two different brushes. Look at the first one. What's the name? Chisel tip. Well, let me find the brush that has a very simple name. Yeah, ballpoint pen. Now this is ballpoint pen, and we have, I don't want to use, yeah, and pencil. Ballpoint pen and pencil. Now master the name carefully. Now we are on pencil. This is how pencil works. Let me draw something. You can see that one is very very small. Now click here. Hope you know what I'm clicking on here. Showing you now. So look at our pencil now. If I click on this last brush, it is on pencil now. See what is going to change to. So now click here. Can you see our brush icon has changed? And what does it change to? Change to ballpoint. Why? I was changing between this pencil and this ballpoint pen. So this is used to change your pencil. That it is now in pencil. If I click again to change to ballpoint, can you see? So it's used to change your last brush. Let's say you are working on pencil before, you are drawing, and with what I'm going to teach you, you feel okay. You need to use okay, this is ballpoint pen. You need to use pencil. Just click here. Sharper laser pencil. Instead of you coming here and start finding it, so since you know your last brush is pencil, you just click here. So hope you understand that. Now let's erase all this. What do you think you're going to use? You're going to use undo. So undo everything. Undo them. Can you see? Now I want us to use something that will make it very very bold. Let's just ballpoint pencil. Let's increase the size. Yeah. So I hope you can see what I drew again. And if you want to change color, cut it here as I've taught you. Sorry. Let's listen to something good. So let's continue. Yeah, I've explained that. Now the next thing I want to work on is this. Can you see it? This. Can you see it? Now let me click on it, and you yourself notice what is going to happen now. You see transparent color. What is it used for? I want you to see what happened. Now you can increase the size here. You can increase the size. I notice anything here. I don't know if you notice anything happening. But let me zoom. See again. Can you notice what's happening? Now, without me explaining, I believe you already understood what's happening here. I believe you understand what's happening here, exactly. I believe. Now, I've already explained how to zoom. We just hold tight two places on the screen and zoom in. See where you zoom out also. Bring it closer, you zoom out. So now, you can see here, what you notice happened. It was erased. It was erased. Now, you see this transparent color is used to erase. It's used to erase. Now, what was the difference between this transparent color and our undo and redo? The difference is because let me change my okay. I think that has been changed already. Yeah, you see this. If I'm sketching, let's say I'm sketching. You still understand what I mean by sketching the next tutorial video. Let's say I'm sketching and I kind of sketch something like this. And the mistake I made is just little like this. You know, if I click on undo, if I click on undo, it's going to really erase what I did, everything I did last. Look at undo now. It erased the whole text and the whole line. Now let's see, what I want to clean is just this little. Let's see, it's just this little. This little alone. See, that's why you have to know the difference between them. Undo will clean everything, but eraser will clean what you wanted to clean specifically. So hope you know the function of everything and I've explained, and hope none of them is hard. They're very, very easy. Now what you do next, let me erase all the color there by using undo. Now we erase all the colors as fast as possible. Now we have no color again. It's showing transparent color. Let's pick a color. So what color should we go for now? Let's go for green. Yeah. Go for green. Okay, there's something I want you to do now. Now there's green here. Let's pick another color. Let's make it yellow. Yeah. There's something I wanted to do here. Let's put yellow here. Let's pick another color. Let's make this one blue. Blue. Now yes, that is enough. Now we've talked about 1, 2, 3. What we'll be moving next is this. Can you see where I'm pointing out? Very close to the little boy's teeth. Very close to his teeth. Yeah. So now it's called color picker. Now let me click on it and see. You yourself see what will happen. Now what do you see? It bring an arrow as if it's a what's the name of all these people say? All these snipers going here. So what you do is, you see the center of this thing, you place it on the color you want to change to. Let's say you want to pick a color, and instead of you finding the color, you find the color on the color you are finding is on the skin. So instead of you stressing yourself to come here and pick the color, you just click on this color picker, sharply put it here. Now you see it's picking blue. Check, our color is blue. Now let's change our color to yellow from the color picker. Click on it and trace it. Can you see? It's changed to yellow. Let's change it to green this time around. Can you see our color is now green? Hope you understand. All these songs, I'm not used to them. They're not giving me good vibes. So, can you see? That's function of color picker. Okay, you can see this teeth is kind of white. So let's click on it to see. So you see, our color change to something whitish. The color is not really white, that's why it is like that, showing whitish brown. Can you see this is somehow brown? So that is function of the color picker. Hope you understand everything. Hope you understand. So let me erase all this color as well. Let me erase them. Yeah, they're not doing anything. So let's move to the 1, 2, 3, fourth default. Can you see I'm clicking on? Can you see? I want you to understand this thing. That's why I'm kind of not rushing and explain everything before we start. Right, once I'm clicking, you understand what I'm clicking on. Yeah, can you see that? So let's click on it and you yourself notice what happened. What does it bring? It brought last color. Do you see any changes in the color? Yes, there's changes in the color. Now we want us to do something again. We'll make use of color picker and lost color and last color. So now first of all, let's pick this pink color. As usual, make a rough sketch here. So let's pick another color again. By now you should know how to pick a color. Let's go for red. By now you should know how to pick a color. Yeah. So you can understand. Now we have two colors. Let me make it three. Yeah. I don't even know the name of this color. Is this sky blue? Something related to that. Now we have three color. Remember, our color picker will help us pick any of the three color. Now, I want to navigate between these two color. So let's say I'm using these two color for my work. So what I will do is pick this color and also pick this color. Now our color is pink. Now let's see, okay, we call this one sky blue. Let's say I want to change my color to sky blue. What do I have to do? It's as simple as anything. Click on this fourth stuff, 1, 2, 3, 4, last color. I know I call it last color. Look at it here. Just click on it. You see our color will have changed from this pink to this sky blue. Now let me show you. Can you see? If I click on last color again, it should move from this sky blue to pink. Now let's click on last color again. Let's check. Can you see? That's a function of last color. So again, you can zoom out. So now let's erase it by clicking on this. Undo. Yeah, it has undo what we did. Now lastly on the list, the fifth, this is the fourth, this is the second, the third. The fourth is last color. Now the fifth is this. Flip canvas. Do you notice any changes? Let me show you once more. It changes the side of the color. Look at where this little boy is facing. It's facing the right hand side. I click on it to make it face the left hand side. So you can see the difference. You can see. So you can make your art look nice. If you can, my pictures thing like this won't make sense. Let me flip it and flip it to the other side. Hope you understand. So that's a function of everything here. I've explained everything. So let's redo this time. We've been undoing and then let's redo it. So can you see our lost color is here again? Let's undo again. Hope you understand. Please, if you don't understand any part of it, kindly do it to us in the group. Do it to us. So now I started with layers. Yeah. So you can kind of delete all these layers I created. Let me delete them. I'm just showing you, you can delete layers too. Now, if you want to start sketching, the first thing you should know is that do not sketch on the skin layer. Look at this. This layer. This is what we call the skin layer. The layer in which your picture is on is the skin layer. Do not sketch on it. The first thing you should do once you import your picture. Let me delete this. Once you import your picture to Autodesk, create a new layer by first of all clicking on this. After you click on it, you click on plus icon. So you can see a new layer has been created. Now you can off this layer, you can also on it. Let me start from this. How do you know you are not working on your skin layer? You will know. You see this last layer is showing something like blue. From that, you know that okay, that's the layer I am on. Let me click on the picture layer. Can you see that blue is on it? You know that okay, we are now on the picture layer. Now, if I'm working here, it's very, very wrong. I shouldn't sketch on the picture layer. So, let's undo this. No more there. So, I've mistakenly undo the layer I clear. So, you create the layer again. Hope you grab. So, and if you want to sketch, make sure you start your sketching from a new layer, this new layer. So you can, as I've said, I wanted to explain this. You can off your layer and on it. Let's off the skin layer. You see the picture will not be there again. You can see it is now white. So it's because we off our skin layer. So if you're having this issue, make sure you do what you on your skin layer. On it. Do not off it. On it. So same thing goes for this layer too. Let me sketch on it. You will see what is going to happen here. Now let me off it. Can you see? It's not showing again. Let me on it. Can you see? So, but now, if I click on this skin layer and I off the skin layer, can you see? What I sketch is showing, but the picture is not showing. Why? Because it is only the skin layer I offed. Let's say I have the skin layer and the new layer I created. The two will not be showing. So now let's on the two back. So hope you understand. So that's our first tutorial video of first tutorial video on Autodesk, which is also at the same time our fourth tutorial video on how to make a cartoon animation. So in our next class, we'll start by sketching. We'll start with sketching. So do well to watch us for our next tutorial video. Please, this tutorial video is very, very important. If you don't know it well, there's no way you can meet up with the next tutorial video. So make sure you watch it well and you understand all what we did. Once again, we are Parrot TV. We don't only entertain you, we entertain you and you get you skilled up. Get you skilled up. Do not forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Meet you in the next video.